So, very good evening to all of you. This is the last session of the FMG series, part 4. I hope I am clearly audible and visible. So just a quick briefing of the Unacademy NEET PG live segment, where you get daily live classes, unlimited access to all the courses for the entire duration of subscription. Then there is Iconic subscription also, which you can avail. Then daily free test series on Unacademy NEET PG live segment on Unacademy app. A very good evening to all of you. Now, to avail the subscription, you need to download the Unacademy Learning app from the Play Store, go to NEET PG segment, select the type of subscription you want, whether Plus or Iconic, then select the duration of subscription. You can apply this referral code to get a discount at the checkout. So let us start with the question answer. These are the batch courses currently which are in progress to cover all 19 subjects for INI CET exams, FMG exams, upcoming NEET PG 2021, all the exams. So this is the first question for today. Batao, answer batao. An artificial condition can be produced using juice of which of the following? अस्सलाम वालेकुम. वालेकुम अस्सलाम. चलो आंसर बताओ. एन आर्टिफिशियल कंट्यूशन कैन बी प्रोड्यूस्ड यूजिंग द जूस ऑफ विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. जियो डेफिनेट सिंह, वेरी गुड. So yes, the correct answer is the juice of marking nut seed. Marking nut is scientifically called Semicarpus anacardium. So juice of either marking nut or juice of calotropis plant can be used to produce artificial contusion or artificial bruise. And this is an offense to produce a bruise and to say that so and so person has hit you. So this is defined in law as fabricating false evidence. Fabricating a false evidence like a false bruise to implicate some other person. So this is defined in which section of Indian law? This is an offense which is defined in. This is defined in 192 IPC. And punishment to the person who has produced the artificial bruise, and if it is proved in the courtroom, then he will be punished accordingly under 193 IPC itself. So 193 defines punishments for both giving false evidence, that is perjury, and fabricating false evidence, defined in 192 IPC. Next question. All are components of black gunpowder except. All are components of black gunpowder except. So black type of gunpowder is mainly used in shotgun except. The question is, three are there. Which one is not present usually in the black gunpowder? Which one is not present? Answer goes with lead peroxide. So potassium nitrate, about 75% is there. Then charcoal is about 15% and 10% of sulfur makes your black gunpowder, mainly used in which cartridges? Shotgun cartridges. Mainly used in shotgun cartridge. Okay. So potassium nitrate ka sabse lamba naam hai. So highest percentage. Uske baad number of alphabets in charcoal is more. So next 15% and sulfur mein sabse kam alphabets hai. So 10%. So this will help you recall the percentages also. Potassium nitrate, charcoal and sulfur. PCS makes your black gunpowder. Answer this one. Pugilistic attitude is seen in which of the following cases will present with pugilistic attitude? Pugilistic attitude is a fencing attitude or boxer's attitude where flexion of your joints occur. So this is seen in extensive burn injury. Ideally the word should be extensive burn injury. So what happens due to extensive burns? There is coagulation of muscle proteins. Coagulation of muscle proteins. And as a result, the person assumes a flexion posture, also called as fencing attitude or boxer's attitude. And always remember, this can be seen even when the person is dead and the dead body is cremated. So there also this attitude can be seen. So it is both antemortem as well as postmortem phenomena. Both antemortem and postmortem phenomena. Antemortem means the person died due to extensive burns. Postmortem means the person was dead and the body was burnt. So it is both antemortem and postmortem. Answer this one. Very simple question. Fracture a la signature is also called as. This is the simplest question for today. Very good. So signature fracture is another name for depressed skull fracture. How depressed fracture is occurring? This occurs due to impact by a heavy weapon with a small surface area. Impact by heavy weapon with small surface area. Best example of such a weapon will be hammer. Best example will be hammer. So based on the external injury, suppose on the scalp, when the hammer is used, over the scalp region also you will get a rounded injuries in the form of abrasions or bruises. Now when we remove the scalp, in the skull bone also, you can get a round fracture like this in the skull vault where the fractured fragments are depressing inside the brain matter. So based on the size of the external injury and the size of the fracture, you can correlate the weapon used. That is why it is also called signature fracture. It signifies the weapon used, called as depressed skull fracture. Out of these four options, which one is the most common type of skull fracture? Which one is the most common type of skull fracture? These are your four options, A, B, C, D. A very good evening to all of you. So most common type of skull fracture is fracture skull is fissured fracture, linear fissured fracture. Option A goes as the correct answer. Gutter fracture is produced due to impact by which weapon? Gutter fracture occurs mainly over there is fracture of outer table. Due to which type of injuries? gutter fracture. A gutter is produced in the outer table like this, only in the outer table, due to tangential gunshots wound, due to tangential gunshots, or I can say glancing bullets, tangential gunshots. When the bullet takes away a part of the outer table, producing a gutter, called as gutter fracture. Ring fractures are fracture around which part of the skull bone? Fracture around which part of the skull bone? Fracture around foramen magnum at the base of the skull. Mostly associated with fall from height cases. Can be seen in road traffic accidents also, but mostly associated with fall from height cases. Next one, lucid interval is most commonly associated with which brain hemorrhage? Lucid interval. अभी रिसेंटली पूछा भी गया है एफएमजी एग्जाम्स में. ऑल ऑफ यू नो दिस आई थिंक. सो ल्यूसिड इंटरवल इज मोस्ट कॉमनली एसोसिएटेड विद ईडीएच केसेस. समटाइम्स कैन बी एसोसिएटेड विद एसडीएच आल्सो. सो इट इज नॉट एक्सक्लूसिवली सीन इन ईडीएच केसेस. व्हाट इज ल्यूसिड इंटरवल? अ पर्सन केम इन अ अनकॉन्शियस स्टेज, देन हिज कॉन्शियसनेस वॉज रिगेन्ड फॉर सपोज 1 to 2 days एंड देन अगेन बिकेम अनकॉन्शियस. So this phase of consciousness between two unconscious phases is called as lucid interval, mostly associated with extradural hemorrhage. This term also is associated with mental illness, or I can say insanity cases, where lucid interval is the person was insane, then he became totally normal, sanity was regained, and then he again became mentally ill or insane. So there also this period of sanity is referred to as lucid interval phase. Next one. A person after being hit by lathis is admitted in a hospital for 20 days. Which of the following indicates grievous hurt? Which of the following indicates grievous hurt? This one is also a very simple question. Keval options lambe lambe, but the answer is very simple. So the person was admitted in a hospital for 20 days. So what should occur for 20 days to call this hit by lathis a grievous hurt? When the person is not able to follow his ordinary pursuits or daily routine activities for a period of 20 days. Along with this, if the person was suffering from severe pain, not for 12, but for 20. So this is also one of the criteria. Under which clause this is written? Any hurt which endangers life or which causes either of the two things for 20 days. Loss of daily pursuits and severe pain for 20 days. So this is which clause of 320 IPC? 8 clauses are there, no? So this is clause number 8 options are there. So this is clause 8. Last clause. Along with these two things, it also covers any hurt which endangers life. So which injuries are any hurt which endangers life? So kaun si injuries endangering life hoti hai? Best example is all head injuries are said to be endangering to life. Any hurt which is endangering to life. is also grievous hurt under clause 8 itself. So best example will be head injuries. Head injuries. Next one. Voluntarily causing grievous hurt by dangerous weapon is punished under which section of IPC? This I have taught many times. And this you all know, I think. So, correct answer to this question is correct answer goes with option D. Very good. This is what 326 IPC says. Grievous hurt by dangerous weapon. So quickly revise those four IPC sections which are related to punishments for injuries. 323, 24, 25 and 326 are there. 23 says I will define the punishment for voluntarily causing hurt. 24 defines the punishment for hurt by dangerous weapon or dangerous means. Dangerous weapon or dangerous means. 25 defines punishment for grievous hurt. And 26 defines punishment for grievous hurt by dangerous weapon. That was the question. So these are your four IPC sections related to punishments for different types of injuries over the body. Come to this one. In which type of hanging constricting force is weight of whole body? Correct answer. In which type of hanging constricting force is weight of whole body? बताओ आंसर बताओ. सिंपल क्वेश्चन. सो देयर आर वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशंस ऑफ हैंगिंग. वन क्लासिफिकेशन इज बेस्ड ऑन द फोर्स ऑफ नेक कंप्रेशन. सो व्हेन द फोर्स ऑफ नेक कंप्रेशन इज बाय द वेट ऑफ होल बॉडी, that hanging is called complete hanging, when the body is completely suspended in air, if some part of the body is touching the ground. Now, weight of the head plays a major role in causing neck compression as compared to weight of body. So, that one is called partial hanging or incomplete hanging. Okay. Typical hanging means when the knot of the ligature material is at mid occipital region, back of neck pe midline mein, mid occipital region. Atypical means not anywhere else, anywhere else. So these are your four different types of hanging deaths based on position of knot and based on the force of neck compression. We classify hanging deaths. Now answer this one. Sexual asphyxias are commonly associated with. Sexual asphyxias are commonly associated with. ये तो सब बता दोगे आप लोग. Sexual asphyxias are commonly associated with partial hanging cases. These sexual asphyxias are also called autoerotic asphyxia. Also called as asphyxiophilia. Asphyxiophilia. And isko hamesha yaad rakhna hai. Okay. सुनर और लेटर यू विल बी आस्क्ड अ क्वेश्चन लाइक दिस. एक और नाम है सेक्सुअल एस्फिक्सियस आर आल्सो कॉल्ड कोट्स वॉरिज्म. कोट्स वॉरिज्म वेयर व्हाट अकर्स अ पर्सन सिटिंग ऑन अ चेयर ही वाज ट्राइंग टू स्टिमुलेट हिज जेनिटल्स बट ही इज नॉट गेटिंग द जेनिटल एक्साइटमेंट एंड देन ही स्टार्टेड वॉचिंग द पोर्नोग्राफिक मटीरियल but then also he is not getting the genital stimulation. So now this fellow uses something which can be used as a ligature around his neck and ties this ligature to the ceiling. And now he is getting that sexual satisfaction or genital stimulation when he is trying to stimulate the genitals. So what is the effect of this ligature? This ligature material will lead to neck compression, and neck compression will compress the sympathetic plexus in your neck, giving rise to sympathetic arousal feeling. But this fellow, in the heat of the excitement, what can happen? This ligature can even kill him. So since the person is sitting on a chair with his feet touching the ground, what you will call this hanging as? Partial hanging. So that was the question. Answer this one. Constricting force required for obliterating carotids in hanging. How much? Carotid arteries. Internal carotid is compressed at what pressure? That is the simple question. Wow. Sab ke sab C bata rahe ho. क्यों भाई ऐसा क्यों? मतलब कि ये क्वेश्चन एग्जाम में आ गया तो सब आप लोग गलत करके आओगे. द करेक्ट आंसर इज 4 to 5 kg. 4 to 5 kg. सो 2 kg इज द प्रेशर इन हैंगिंग डेथ्स विच कॉजेस कंप्रेशन ऑफ अबाउट ऑफ योर इंटरनल जगलर वेन. For carotids to be compressed, you need a pressure of about 4 to 5 kg. For your airways to be compressed, you need a pressure of about 15 kg. Larynx and trachea. So the question was carotids, not larynx and trachea. Okay? So B will be the correct answer. Iska answer batao. All are different types of strangulations except. All are different types of strangulations except. So you need to remember the classification of asphyxial death. What are the different types of hanging deaths, different types of strangulation deaths, and different types of drowning deaths? A potential question zone. So, buns, dola, garroting, mugging, all are different types of strangulation deaths. But what is gagging? Gagging is obstruction of oronasopharynx. Oropharynx and nasopharynx. By suppose like a handkerchief is used to obstruct your oro and nasopharynx. So, that is called gagging. Buns dola is strangulation by bamboo sticks when they are used to crisscross the neck and compress the neck. Garroting is compression of the neck, strangulation by iron collars. Mugging is strangulation by either bend of elbow like this or bend of knee. Bend of elbow or bend of knee. Or sole of foot. So the mechanism will be called as mugging when these body parts are used to kill a person. Bend of elbow, bend of knee, or sole of foot. Will you get a ligature mark in cases of mugging? Leading question. Question to be answered in yes or no. Will you get a ligature mark in mugging? Yes or no? Ligature mark over neck. Leading questions normally asked during cross-examination of a witness. So suppose I am cross-examining you. So ligature mark in mugging, whether it will be seen or not. Yes or no? All of you are confident? So yes, ligature mark in mugging, answer goes with no. Okay. Because the area is broad, broad surface and body part. So there is no distinctive ligature mark as such. But yes, internal neck findings will be there and the person will be killed because of internal neck hemorrhages, vessels damage, muscular, the bruising of vessels, then your hemorrhages in the muscular layers. They will be found when we dissect out the neck. Answer this one. Which type of drowning is associated with raised potassium levels in the body? Which type of drowning is associated with hyperkalemia? All of you are confident? Yes. So correct answer goes with yes, freshwater drowning. Because in freshwater, what happens? Your alveolus becomes filled with water. All the terminal alveolar units, इनका पहले काम क्या था? Gaseous exchange. अब ये gaseous exchange तो कर नहीं पाएंगे, इसलिए person का death होता है. एक तो ये कारण है. दूसरा, alongside the alveolar units, you have your RBCs in the pulmonary vessels. So now, if I compare these two compartments, alveolus and RBC compartment, because the water is fresh, RBCs have got rich potassium ions. So, इनका solute concentration ज़्यादा हो जाता है. So, they start attracting water. All the RBCs in the pulmonary vessels, they will start attracting water from the alveolar units. तो इससे क्या होगा? Rupture of RBCs will occur. Swelling and rupture of RBCs. And finally, they will release lots of potassium ions, which will lead to ventricular fibrillation and death within 3 to 4 minutes. Which one is more dangerous? Freshwater or salt water? कौन सा ज्यादा डेंजरस होता है? नदी का पानी या सब सी वाटर? आंसर गोज विथ फ्रेश वाटर ड्रॉन, बिकॉज हियर डेथ अकर्स अर्लियर ड्यू टू वेंट्रिकुलर फिब्रिलेशन इन 3 to 4 minutes. इन सी वाटर इट टेक्स अबाउट 8 to 10 minutes फॉर द पर्सन टू डाई. सो फ्रेश वाटर इज ऑलवेज मोर डेंजरस ड्यू टू दिस इलेक्ट्रोलाइट डिस्टर्बेंस इन द बॉडी. Answer this one. Brush burn. क्या होता है brush burn? What is brush burn? Brush burn is which? So brush burn is a type of abrasion. Which type of abrasion is called brush burn? Answer this also. Brush burn is which type of abrasion? What is that abrasion called? I can say the brush burn is most common type of abrasions also. So which are the most common type of abrasions? Most common type of abrasions over the body are? नहीं, अब्रेशन, अब्रेशन, ग्रेज्ड अब्रेशन. हाँ हाँ हाँ, ए इज बर्न्स प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय लाइटनिंग. करेक्ट कुसुम. बर्न्स प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय लाइटनिंग इन अबाउट 30% ऑफ द केसेस ओनली. इन अबाउट 30% ऑफ द केसेस यू गेट अ ब्रांचिंग ऑफ ट्री पैटर्न ओवर द बॉडी सरफेस कॉल्ड एज फिलिग्री बर्न्स. Burn at firearm entry wound will lead to which important finding surrounding the entry wound? flame effect surrounding an entry wound will lead to singeing or burning of hairs. Singeing or burning of hairs. What do you call this burn as? Burn produced by high voltage have been given a typical name. They are called as high voltage means 10,000 volts, 12,000 volts. So those burns are called crocodile burns. Crocodile burns. So that's all for today. Today the number of questions were more. इसके synonyms और क्या क्या है filigree burns के? It is also called Lichtenberg flower pattern burn. Also called as coronographic burns. Also called as arborescent burns. कई सारे नाम है. And these synonyms become important questions. But always remember, this is seen only in 30% cases of lightning, filigree burns. So, coming back to this batch course, like my schedule for the FMG 2021 is on, few students were asking this, my schedule is in March month. So, in March month, on every weekend, we will be having classes on Saturday and Sunday for FM subject. Rest of the days, different subjects are there. So every Saturday and Sunday. And the timing is like this, 12 to 2 and 2:30 to 4:30. Half an hour interval on both Saturday and Sunday. This timing will be followed. Means 4 hours every Saturday and Sunday. So by March end, by 27th March, I will be completing your FM subject for your FMG exams in this batch course. This is for FMG exams. This is a target batch course. So all 19 subjects are there. I'm just telling the schedule of my subject. Rest of the days, like on weekdays, there are different subjects. And in March, you have your Holi also. On 29th March, so I'll be finishing your syllabus on 27th March itself. Chalo then, bye-bye. And for subscribing on Academy Neet PG segment, you can use this referral code. One or two students subscribed without the referral code. Why to leave the discount of 10%? You should avail the discount. Chalo, bye-bye. Bye-bye.